When I was a child, I was curious about light and rainbow. Why? A rainbow is filled with such beautiful color and with curved shape. Later, I learned that the origin of everything, including light, starts with the atom. The Maulana, Persian poet, wrote, "Look inside the tiniest particle, you can find universe inside." So let's to look at the tiniest particle, atoms. The universe, when the nature put the atom together, the combination create a palette of color to decorate the world around us, and also give rise to the functional complexity of nature. The wing of the butterfly, the feather of a peacock, the sheen of a pearl, all are examples of photonic crystal, nanostructure of the arrangement of the atoms that capture and recast the color of rainbow with iridescent beauty. Different atoms create light with different color or energy when oscillating from gamma ray, X-ray, ultraviolet, visible, infrared, down to terahertz. However, our eyes can see only a small part of this total electromagnetic spectrum, the color of rainbow. Physicists have discovered, in order to detect and create light in the whole electromagnetic spectrum, is required first to have the profound understanding of the structure of atom through quantum mechanics and a kind of a special material called semiconductor, the heart of all modern electronic and photonic. To see beyond the visible light, scientists have invented artificial eyes, such as infrared camera. However, there still exists frontier within invisible light spectrum that we cannot detect. To both see or shine light in each wavelength band required a team of scientists to invent new model, new material, and new devices. This is what my group at my Center for Quantum Device is dedicated to, exploring this frontier of unseen by developing the technology for both detecting and creating light from deep UV up to terahertz. First, let me to start by deep UV. They are low short wavelength and high energy, make it one of the most challenging wavelength to build quantum devices such as lasers, detector, and artificial eyes for. To emit and detect light in deep UV, a spectrum that has many different applications, I designed the specialized epitaxial reactor that can grow atom by atom some semiconductor material that they are required to build these quantum semiconductor deep UV devices. One of the important research projects in my group for this deep UV quantum device is to provide us the ability to disinfect the surfaces just by shining this UV light on them. The deep UV light deactivates the DNA of bacteria, virus, pathogen to destroy their ability to multiply and create disease. For example, for COVID-19 virus, it was found that this UV light that we developed can kill more than 100%, 99% virus on the surfaces just in 1 second. This light can also kill the virus in the air that we breathe. By pairing this UV light with UV detector, we can create a compact system that can rapidly detect and identify some harmful biological agents such as anthrax and tyrosine in air and on the surfaces. These are very important applications for health and safety, but still is in research phase. The another important wavelength gap is in the terahertz, very long wavelength and low energy, also make it one of the most difficult and challenging wavelength to build the room temperature terahertz, laser diodes, detector, and artificial eyes for. By designing a new epitaxial reactor, we tried to grow atom by atom some semiconductor material that can build these terahertz quantum devices. By pairing exquisite semiconductor material with new innovative laser design has led my group to demonstrate the first room temperature compact semiconductor terahertz laser diode. This terahertz laser diode, the artificial eyes and detector could have far-reaching impact in healthcare and global communication over next 5-10 years. Terahertz frequency, terahertz light, has many unique applications and properties that is unique. They can pass through many kinds of material, including textile, synthetic, paper, board. Unlike X-ray, terahertz light do not have ionizing effect because they have low energy, and that generally make it biologically harmless. So the terahertz light can be much safer and healthier to use for security check or medical diagnosis. The next important application for the future is the area of wireless communication. Terahertz frequency is order of magnitude higher than those we use at present on for the wireless internet. There is a potential to apply terahertz technology for the next generation of high-speed telecommunication. The higher the frequency of light, the faster the data is sent and information can be delivered. One of our goals is to create compact, mass-producible, room temperature operation, terahertz laser diodes with high output power in order to enable technology for above-mentioned application and so many more. I have been able to give you just a glimpse into our invention of variety of semiconductor, quantum lasers, detector, artificial eyes that can detect and create light from different wavelengths from deep UV up to terahertz. This semiconductor quantum device have also a huge impact in our daily life from food, energy, transportation, communication, health, medicine, exploration of space and under ocean. It was time no one could believe we could create such advanced quantum semiconductor devices. But by working hard, having passion for learning, and exploiting new ideas, we have shown impossible to be possible. Our knowledge about comprehensive importance of light is age old. Even ancient news that the light is the source of all energy, is a symbol of hope, is a mean for curing illnesses. Light is more than a technological medium, is a source of the beauty of our world. Light is a message from remotest depths of space. So I ask, look inside the tiniest particle, you will find universe inside. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.